So after receiving your assignment to present on a topic of interest, you start researching. You plug in your keywords and key phrases. The problem is the results are all over the place and there are so many of them. What do you do now? No worries. There's a solution to this. Today we're going to talk about how to turn your research topic into a research question. This is not only going to help you focus and get less overwhelming results, but it'll also help you present on what really interests you about the topic. Let's go ahead and jump in. Oh, sorry about that. Have you ever found yourself wandering down the YouTube rabbit hole? You know, maybe you started with a YouTube video on the most satisfying and relaxing TikTok compilation.
Then on the side, you saw like slow motion of dog lapping up water.
And that got you thinking, how do cats drink water? And then before you know it, you're looking at cats knocking down toddlers and toddler fails. And then you're in a weird, or in this case, cute part of YouTube, and you can't even remember how you got there.
Research can be really similar to the YouTube rabbit hole. Let's say you start with a topic like sharks. This could lead you down really different paths. For example, you might find yourself finding articles on sharks and the presence of algae, maybe sharks in pop culture, and this is where it gets tricky. Which path do you follow? That's where the research question comes in. Topics, while a great starting point, can be incredibly broad. A research question is how you can focus your search so that you don't find yourself falling down that research rabbit hole. Think about your topic for a moment. What is it that you're actually interested in? Are there any subtopics connected to your topic? Which of those subtopics do you find most fascinating? These questions can help you turn your topic into a research question. And keep in mind, often you can let research that exists inspire your focus area. Maybe during your initial broad topic search, you were finding a lot of articles on sharks and pop culture, and that's fascinating to you. Great! Let that become your research question. Inspired by sharks and pop culture, let's work through an example together. So we have our two topics, sharks and pop culture. Take 5 minutes or so to develop a research question based on these two topics. Remember, it's all about being curious. What types of questions do these topics inspire? If you'd like, go ahead and pause the video right now, take those 5 minutes, and then discuss together. So how'd it go? I did a bit of brainstorming myself, and these are the questions that I came up with. Where, when are sharks portrayed in pop culture? Easy. How are sharks portrayed in pop culture? Medium. And how does the portrayal of sharks in pop culture affect treatment from humans? High. So probably notice the whole easy, medium, high deal. That's because there are such things as easy research questions. These tend to be more direct and the answers tend to be on the simpler side. Then you have those research questions that are diving a bit deeper and are considered higher quality. If you find a question that demands a bit more critical thinking and searching in different areas, you're in that high quality zone, meaning the research will likely be more focused and more engaging. Just something to keep in mind. Now that we have our research question, we can revisit any keywords or key phrases that we might have already brainstormed, maybe modify or add to them as needed. Some examples for shark in pop culture are here on the screen. So you can use words like television, TV, film, movie, cartoon villains, Sharknado maybe, and so on. Other things to consider call back to Research Skills 101. What kind of sources should we consider? Maybe newspapers, maybe peer-reviewed journals, a combination of the two? Are there others that might prove useful? Just something to think about as you start your research. Now it's your turn to apply this to your own topic. Start that questioning process. What is it that you're actually interested in regarding your topic? Do you need tips or a starting point? Do a starting search either in the library's quick search or even in Google. What stands out to you? Maybe brainstorm a few different directions to take your topic. In our previous example, we talked about sharks in pop culture. Other topics could be sharks in climate change, sharks in the Texas coast, sharks in algae. The possibilities are out there. It's really just a matter of figuring out what you want to know. Today, we talked about how to go from a research topic to a research question. Doing this helps us take a really broad topic and narrow it into a question that we can answer with research. Remember, the higher the quality of the question, the better. Good luck with your search.